A portion of today's video is brought to you by Brilliant. Wind generates enough energy to produce about 35 times more electricity than the entire planet could use in each day. It's free, clean, and renewable, so why don't we see more wind turbines used on rooftops like solar panels? In a nutshell, it's the blades. More moving parts means more complexity, and you don't have to worry about that with solar. But what if we can contain those moving parts in a way that's safer and more efficient? Using a similar design as the wings on race cars, Aeromine Technologies has done just that. Its turbine works on rooftops without exposed blades, all while taking up far less space than solar panels. Can the Aeromine make generating wind energy on rooftops a breeze? I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. Along with other renewables, the use of wind energy is growing. In 2021, turbines contributed about 9% of the utility-scale generation of electricity here in the U.S., which is a big jump from less than 1% in 1990. Wind also produces a lot more power than solar in general. Last year, wind energy generated more than twice the electricity of solar here in the United States. As effective as wind turbines can be, they still have their limitations. That's because the giant propellers that you see dotting the landscapes are imposing in more ways than one. Their high upfront costs, maintenance requirements, and effects on wildlife all present significant challenges. Now, small wind turbines, or SWTs, are no different, with factors like their sound, height, and aesthetics often hindering the practicality. Now, they can vibrate, which leads to both noise and structural issues. Unstable wind flows can cause turbulence, stressing the turbine's components, and nearby buildings can affect the wind path, significantly reducing their power capacity. Basically, there's a reason why you probably associate wind turbines with rolling hills and over the ocean, not gables and chimneys. They're just not as easy to adapt to rooftops the way solar panels are. We've discussed these difficulties in depth in a previous video, and I'll put a link down in the description about that. Aeromine aims to solve that problem. The company claims that its motionless turbine can generate as much as 50% more energy than solar panels using 10% of the space. To understand how the Aeromine can accomplish this, though, we need to take a quick step back and explain how conventional wind turbines work. It all comes down to the airfoils. Anything that you need to function aerodynamically requires one. Airplanes, helicopters, pinwheels, and of course, wind turbines. In fact, turbines in the US initially used the same airfoil type as the airplane wings before scientists developed blade-specific ones. Without the feather-like shape of airfoils, we wouldn't be able to conquer the skies. The purpose of an airfoil is to make physics work for you. Both turbines and airplanes want more lift than drag, so they use airfoils to take advantage of the Bernoulli effect. And this refers to how gases and liquids flow around an object at different speeds. A slower moving fluid, like air, will build up more pressure than a faster moving fluid. And this forces objects towards the faster moving fluid. The layout of an airplane wing causes air to flow faster over the top side and slower on the bottom side. This results in the bottom side producing the higher air pressure needed for lift that gets planes off the ground, and the blades of turbines moving. As the rotor of the turbine spins, it powers the generator, producing electricity. In the case of auto racing, though, you don't want your car to go flying. That's why both the contours of the car's chassis and the wings that engineers stick on the surface are upside-down airfoils. As the air underneath the car moves faster than the air above it, negative lift or downforce pushes down onto it. The downforce stabilizes vehicles and allows them to maintain speed as they turn corners. So what does this have to do with Aeromine? Well, the airfoils on the race cars are stationary, and so are the Formula One-style airfoils that power the company's turbine. Looking at it from the exterior, there's no exposed moving parts. Instead, two vertically mounted hollow foils stand opposite each other with a space in between them. This creates a low pressure zone, and as the wind flows through the space, it's drawn through perforations in the wings. A short pipe then leads the captured wind to a fully enclosed turbine located at ground level. Several of the weaknesses that hold typical turbines back are addressed by the structure of the Aeromine. Because the turbine generator is housed inside, it's both protected from extreme weather and inaccessible to people and animals, eliminating a major safety concern. The company claims that the Aeromine is silent and that its lack of exposed moving parts means less maintenance. It also can operate with wind speeds as low as 5 miles per hour, about 8 kilometers per hour. Now, in contrast, conventional turbines need speeds of about 9 miles per hour or 15 kilometers or higher to operate. So how do Aeromines compare to solar? Well, right now the answer is a little vague, or at least not verified. Its website claims that a single Aeromine unit can provide the same amount of power as up to 16 solar panels, but doesn't offer any specifics. But we do have a rough idea of what the Aeromine might be capable of, though, because the company participated in a 2021 Reimagining Energy Challenge, a US Department of Defense crowdfunding program. At its virtual booth, Aeromine rates its turbines at 5 kilowatts and estimates that each one could produce 14.3 megawatt hours annually. And to put that in perspective, A 5 kilowatt rating is comparable to the power of an average 21 panel rooftop home solar system. Now, these types of setups generally produce about 4.5 megawatt hours of electricity in a year. As for costs, a 2019 analysis published by Aeromine in collaboration with Sandia National Laboratories and Texas Tech University estimated that the turbine could be installed at about $2,400 per kilowatt. By comparison, the average cost of constructing solar panels of all types was $1,655 per kilowatt in 2020. However, only time will tell how much the actual costs of the Aeromine matches up to the company's estimate. Let's be clear though, Aeromines are not the kind of turbine that you'll be seeing on a single family home. In the company's own words, they're intended for large, flat, rooftop buildings, like warehouses, data centers, and big box retail stores. And remember, the airfoils are stationary. The angle won't change even when the wind's direction does. So they're best suited for locations where there isn't much variation in the wind's direction. Aeromines aren't commercially available yet, and the company hopes to have them on the market by 2023. However, one unit is currently undergoing testing on top of the roof of a BASF Corporation manufacturing plant in Wyandotte, Michigan. Now, in theory, a fully deployed Aeromine system would look like 20 to 40 turbines lining the edge of a building in a row, spaced about 4.6 meters apart and facing the predominant wind direction. The company emphasizes that because the turbines leave room for panels, they're complementary to solar, allowing for power production to continue after sunset or on cloudy days. Luckily, we don't have to wait for Aeromine to witness the potential of rooftop wind energy with solar panels. The Dutch company Ibis Power is already demonstrating the benefits of combining solar panels with small turbines with a form of installation called a power nest. Now, power nests are specifically designed to blend in with the existing architecture of a city. They require a flat roof on a building with a minimum of 5 floors. Attempting to harness wind energy in a metropolitan area usually isn't logistically possible, but power nests integrate small turbines, funnels, and solar panels into what Ibis refers to as a modular kinetic sculpture to maximize the amount of electricity a single roof can produce. In each nest, turbines and funnels lie beneath a raised platform of bifacial solar panels. The company claims that this arrangement provides as much as 6 times more energy than solar panels could generate alone. So how is this possible? With more physics. This time, the Venturi effect. Have you ever held your thumb over the end of a garden hose while the water was on and noticed that the flow speeds up? That's the Venturi effect in action. As a fluid moves through a constricted space, like a funnel, its velocity increases. Ibis claims that the power nest's use of the Venturi effect accelerates the wind speed by 140 to 160%. Its turbines can also turn in wind speeds as low as 4.5 miles per hour. Meanwhile, the solar panels are optimized through their placement on a raised platform, which means covering a bit more than the entire area of the roof, rather than only about 40%. Plus, the wind cools the solar panels as it travels below them, which can translate into a 10 to 25% boost in efficiency. Europe saw the construction of the first commercial power nest in 2019, and so far, the results seem promising in terms of how well it gets along with its neighbors. According to a 12-month study of a demo version of the power nest, an installation atop a residential complex in the Dutch city of Utrecht, and I know I mispronounced that, sorry for that, it caused no noise or vibration in the apartment below it. The building's residents didn't have any complaints, and the company states that it discovered 0 bird or bat casualties inside or near the system. This past July, Ibis constructed a power nest atop Hasha Over, and I'm sorry to all the Dutch speakers, I'm probably butchering these names, but it's a 70-meter residential tower in the Dutch city of Eindhoven. Now, with 296 solar panels and 4 turbines, the company estimates the modules will generate no less than 140 megawatt hours a year. Ibis is in the midst of installing more power nests in the Netherlands and Belgium, and the company's CEO, Alexander Suma, has also expressed interest in major US cities like Boston and New York. Concepts like the Aeromine and the power nest show us that small wind turbines can not only be effective independently, but even more impactful in the way that they can diversify our renewable energy sources, meaning more energy generation, more of the time. It's like peanut butter and chocolate. Why have one when you can have both? If you'd like to learn more about some of the concepts behind these wind turbines and the physics involved, I'd strongly recommend checking out the Classical Mechanics and Electricity and Magnetism courses at today's sponsor, Brilliant. All of the courses are highly interactive, and the Classical Mechanics course covers things like conservation of energy and drag forces, which applies directly to wind turbines. And the Electricity and Magnetism course will walk you through how kinetic energy is used to generate electricity to power the things that we use every single day. And these courses have helped me to refresh my knowledge and wrap my head around some of the more complex topics. There's so many other lessons to choose from, everything from logic to solar energy. The more we understand the science behind these problems, the better we can solve them. And you can go at your own pace, learning a little bit each day. But the best part is how hands-on the interactive courses are, which is the best way to learn. Join over 11 million people learning on Brilliant today. Go to brilliant.org/undecided to sign up for free. And also the first 200 people will get 20% off their annual premium membership. Thanks to Brilliant and to all of you for supporting the channel. So what do you think? Do you think any of these wind turbine concepts have a shot? Jump in the comments and let me know. And be sure to check out my follow-up podcast, Still to be Determined, where we'll be discussing some of your feedback. If you like this video, be sure to check out one of the ones over here. And thanks to all of my patrons for your continued support. Your help really makes these videos possible. And thanks to all of you for watching. I'll see you in the next one.